years ago that I first met Armando. I was living with my ex-girlfriend at the time, and he hung out with a mutual friend of ours. They went to film school together. I didn't know then that meeting this person would change my life and put me where I am today. Here's the story of Ducky and how that came to be.
It's in the LSD music video too, right?
It is.
My first impression of Armando was definitely, he was hanging out with the weird black guys, you know what I mean? Like, he was hanging with black guys, and it was like, I was hanging with my crowd, but he had like the Tyler the Creator type crowd, you know what I mean? And it was dope though.
I didn't like him very much. I saw him across the room from me, and I was like, who is this kid? I think he is over there, sitting in the corner with his headphones in, head down on the desk.
From the beginning, he always had a very particular energy about him that I don't think I've found anywhere else. If I had to describe it, I would say it's more of just a very light energy. He's very, just a very kind person, very kind soul, very uncorrupted, it feels like at times. And sometimes I think that kind of leads somebody to believe like naivete almost, you know what I mean? Just so kind, so uncorrupted, like especially at that time, you know, much less now. I remember before we moved into the house, and every single time we would talk about room arrangements, right? Like who's gonna be stationed next to Rich's room, Ducky would always be like, bro, I make weird ass sounds at night when I record music. Just be aware of that. And it was every single day. I'm like, bro, like the fact that he wants to be loved by everybody makes him basically try and warn you about things that he does and his habits over and over and over again. But it's like, bro, we love you. Like, we don't give a fuck. You know what I mean?
He's like head in the clouds, but in a good way. And then like down to earth, sometimes I just wonder, just like, what are you thinking about right now, man? Like, what made you do that right there? Why are we walking into this restaurant asking for water? We just walk out right afterwards. Like, what is happening?
Ice age heat wave, can't complain. If the world's at large, why should I remain?
Yeah, Mondo's super smart. Ever since I met him, he's super smart. That's how we became friends. We're just talking about ideas. And then because he was a film student, so that's why I felt that. And that clash, I was like, who is this guy who thinks he's better than me? Yeah, Armando's a great guy. He's probably one of the most honest guys I know, you know. He likes to have very open conversations, so sometimes he'll just come in my room and say, hey man, if there's anything you don't like about me, tell me right now. You know, and he just like wants to just be on good terms with everybody all the time and make sure there's never animosity or anything like that. He doesn't really enjoy negative energy.
Allowed him to feel that he's a free-minded person, and I think that translates into the music, because if his mind wasn't so free and like uncluttered by like boundaries, then I don't think that he would be able to make the type of music that he makes. But because he doesn't feel like he has to be gangster, for example, because he doesn't feel like he has to be anything, he just seems like he has to be himself, that allows him to create in a different way than most artists are able to create. Mm-hmm.
Fucking happy. What the fuck? No!
bless them with this song.
So many similarities with Ducky, dude. Like, that shit's just so crazy. We both fucking use Audacity. We both are part of like two collectives that like fucking host shows and shit. We're both like the artists of the group. I can experiment as much as I want with around Ducky. And I was like off the get go. And I just spoke with him as a person and I spoke with a lot of his ideology on, like, as far as like pushing himself out as an artist and like working with the company. The first time we recorded music, and I was staying over at your guys' place. We just stayed up from the time I got there, probably like 7, and we're just going back and forth. But like throughout like the middle, probably like the second verse, it was just funny because like I would go finish writing my verse while Ducky would take a nap. Stay in this mess, sleep in the fucking kitchen while I'm fucking recording.
I heard his music and I know what's good and what's not good. You know, I have a lot of friends who make music, but I have a lot of friends who I invest into their music career, you know? Like, there's a lot of people who I know who make music, but are they good enough to break through? I would like to think all my friends have the potential to do that, but in reality, I feel like he really does have the potential to do that.
Just fucking wait, man. Literally, just fucking wait. There's so much shit. You're just getting a little glimpse of a lane of versatility, but I'm just excited for Ducky to put out a lot more music for people that know who he is. Yeah.
Thinking inside the box, I would go read a book or something, you know what I mean? Smoke a J. Like, open your mind, take some shrooms or some shit. Open their mind up a little bit, massage your bitch. And those are the type of things that I would do before listening to the music, you know what I mean?
Heard this interview.
Fuck you.